Welcome to another unit in this Excel course, and in particular in this unit I'm going to talk about the so-called exponential distribution. The exponential distribution is also known as the distribution without recollection. What does this actually mean? Well, imagine I'm running my computer here and I want to know what the probability is that my computer will crash in the next 2 hours. Well, in this case, if I assume that crashing of the computer is distributed following the exponential distribution, then this means it doesn't matter how long the computer already has been running, whether it's been running like 3 weeks in a row or I just booted this, does not matter. It's only like from now on that it crashes in the next 2 hours. So whatever happened before doesn't matter, only from now onwards. And well, when we calculate something like this, we're actually only needing two values. The first value, that's like the 2 from the 2 hours. And the other one, that's more or less like the average, the expected value. However, here in this context, I'm not using this as expected value, but I'm using the inverse of the expected value. So basically here, first off, I need to have my testing value, my 2 hours. Then I have my expected value. I'm just calling this expected value. For example, let's say my computer would crash every 24 hours. Then I need to get the inverse thereof, and this is what we call here the parameter lambda. The parameter lambda, as I said, that's the inverse of the expected value. Well, if I have this, I can simply calculate the probability that my computer will crash within the next 2 hours, so p of x being smaller or equal to 2, as exponential, then this for distribution. Then he wants to have two values, my x value, here the 2 hours, and my lambda, so the 0.04 something. And he also wants to know whether I want to have the value for the density function or for the cumulative distribution function. Well, in the exponential distribution, similar to the normal distribution, similar to most of the continuous distributions you will be using, you might always only be considering like a lesser or equal to, because first off, the equality case, it's always zero, and the probability density function doesn't really tell you a lot. So here, if we are concerned about the probabilities, we're usually working with the cumulative distribution function, thereby we usually put here a true. Well, if I do this in this case, then this would tell me that the probability that my computer will crash within the next 2 hours is roughly 8%. Again, assuming that on average it will crash every 24 hours. And well, that's already everything there is to using Excel to get probabilities with regard to the exponential distribution. Well, if you like this, want to see more, want to see different distributions or more on Excel, feel free to visit the rest of the course or have a look in the corresponding playlist. I say goodbye and see you next time.